This project is about making ball bearing canister Damascus, a pattern often called dragon scale or dragon hide. It's something I've wanted to try for a very long time, and this is my first attempt. Like all canister Damascus builds, this starts with a piece of steel tubing welded shut on one end. Inside the canister, I sprayed regular white paint, and I also lined the walls with stainless steel sheet, again painted white. This helps prevent the billet from welding itself to the canister during the forge weld. For the contents, I'm using 1095 powder steel and small ball bearing roughly 3 mm in diameter. Now, I won't make you wait until the end of the video for the conclusion. This project failed, and the reason is actually visible already at this early stage. If you look closely at the ball bearings, some of them have a slightly different color. At the time, I didn't notice, but those balls turned out to be stainless steel, not high carbon steel like the rest. And you might think this isn't a big problem since stainless canister Damascus is possible, but in this situation, those stainless balls ended up causing the entire billet to fail. You'll see exactly how by the end of the video. Once the canister is filled all the way to the top, I add a bit of paper inside, and this burns up any remaining oxygen during the initial heat. Then, using the press cold, I push the cap down about a millimeter into the tube. This compresses everything nice and tight and creates a small lip, which makes it easy to weld the cap almost all the way around. I just leave a tiny vent hole for gases to escape, and then I weld on a rebar handle so the canister is easier to hold during forging. Now, before we continue, let me take a moment to show you one of my new favorite books.
The book The Ultimate Guide for Rebuilding Civilization is basically an illustrated encyclopedia of humankind's greatest inventions and discoveries. It's full of hand-drawn illustrations that blend engineering drawing with medieval art, and is just beautiful to flip through. I honestly think the whole book is great, but I especially love the section about forging, which of course is right up my alley, and the part about tools. There's even this old microscope in the optics section that made me smile, because I actually have almost the exact same model from 1927, and now, thanks to the book, I can understand better how it actually works and all the different parts, which is amazing. The book is one of those things you can leave on a coffee table, and anyone who's curious about how things work will end up flipping through it for hours. So yeah, it also makes for a perfect gift. I really like it myself. If you want to check it out, there's a link in the video description below. The book The Ultimate Guide to Rebuilding Civilization by Angry Minds, and you can get 10% off by using my promo code BLACKBEARD.
Alright, back to the forge. The canister goes in and soaks at a high temperature for a good while, and the goal here is to make sure the entire billet reaches an even heat all the way through, which is critical for a successful forge weld. At the hydraulic press, I start with 45 degrees V-dies. These are perfect for the initial consolidation, and I rotate the billet between presses to make sure it's compressed evenly on all sides and corners, and after a few passes, I switch back to flat dies. This is where I can really start moving the material and squishing the billet into a flatter bar, something that would eventually be usable for a blade. After a while, the canister starts to crack and peel off. You can see the glowing material inside, and at this point, everything still looks promising. And this is where I stop forging and let the billet cool so I can remove the canister. I score it with an angle grinder, pry the sides open, and pull the billet out. But even from this distance, you can see something doesn't look quite right. Off camera, I tried grinding out some of the cracks and squaring the billet up, hoping the defects might be superficial. Unfortunately, they weren't. This is the result, and it looks like Swiss cheese. Definitely not what you want to see in a piece of steel. If you look closely, some of the material is actually solid, but several of the ball bearings never welded at all. Of course, the stainless one I mentioned earlier. I also ground and etched one end of the billet to show what the pattern would have looked like, and here is very clear. The stainless balls remained completely unwelded, which makes this material unusable. Lesson learned, make sure you're not using stainless ball bearings. That said, there is a positive side to this failure. Something else I learned from this process that I can improve on next time, and that's pattern distortion. As you can see, the billet was forged too much in one direction, which stretched the pattern unevenly, because what I really wanted were round shapes in the Damascus, not ovals. So when I try this again, that's something I'll be focusing on. And that's it for this project. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this kind of honest project video. Things don't always work out the way you expect, but there's always something to learn from it. And sometimes that's the most interesting part of the process. Thanks again for watching. Take care. And I'll see you soon in the next project. Bye bye.